And he starts up front with Dominik Kubalík, the rookie scoring leader in the entire league, and Kirby Dock. They will be played as scheduled, but in front of an empty arena. Here is a feed right across. Oh, and a great save and a rebound. Follow up by Nason. And that one would not go. Corey Crawford stepping up big in his 10th consecutive start here for the Blackhawks.
Went from a 3-on-2 to a 2-on-1 to a pretty much a partial breakaway.
Here's a chance for Gregor and a save made and a cover by Crawford. Jostled a bit there. Connor Murphy's father, Gord, probably played against him. This one is fired against Thornton. Meanwhile, this is fired towards the net, and that blocked up high. Nylander, meanwhile, this comes back out, and it's Evander Kane flinging one on, trying to get there. It's Gregor. Gregor centered one in front. Oh, and Kane with a great shot, and a stop there by Crawford, and a penalty is coming up. Evander Kane lost it right around in front. An attempt there would not work for LeBanc. Right back over for Thornton. Gets it on to Sorensen, back to Thornton. Oh, it's a score! Great deflection at the front of the net. Evander Kane has made it 1-0, 6 seconds from the expiration of the first of the two penalties.
5-on-3, San Jose working the puck out high. And then eventually they went down and started tacking down low, and Thornton with an absolute perfect pass to Evander Kane, who eludes the stick of Slater Cuckoo and elevates that puck past the right shoulder of Corey Crawford.
Yeah, there was very little seam plays for the Sharks, very little one-timer options, and you could tell that Thornton was looking for this particular play.
Gaul went up from the crowd, which thus far seems to be pretty substantial here. Gliding along with it now, Cuckoo fed in front, oh, and saw it, could not connect, as lurching it, that one was Dell. Drop back on now by Toews. Onto the back to Keith. Return back to him by Toews. Keith, a drive. Score!
So Jeremy Colton said, a good play here by Jonathan Toews to exchange with Duncan Keith, but then the mentality to get that puck to the net. A good screen in front by Kirby Dock, taking the eyes away of Aaron Dell. And the Hawks have themselves a tie hockey game.
And you mentioned that. Watch Duncan Keith here. He's going to pull the puck, and then no chance for Dell because of the big body of Dock. That's the way you take away the eyes of the goaltender. And it's not a really hard shot by Duncan Keith at all, but certainly effective because of the screen.
But if not, when the team gets back, here is Patrick Kane right around in front. Oh, and getting a piece of that sprawling across the net mouth was Dell. Lucas Carlson dropped that one back. Meanwhile, this is worked on and into some traffic by Burns. Squib back out, and here's Strom. Oh, and what a stop made by Dell. Wow. Vlasic gets the return pass from Kanishov. Then it is fed back over now for a toss to the front that ricocheted right in on Crawford off of Nason on the toss from Joel Schellman. Nylander moving ahead, puts on the brakes from his knees, rolled it along, hoping for Patrick Kane. Got Burns instead, wrong 88. Drive off the post on the shot that came from Beaudin. Meanwhile, coming by is Dock, but jamming along further is Hagel, and Hagel stepped free and a shot. Oh, and that one wouldn't go. What a great chance there as he just walked toward the net, strides there and coasts on one leg in all the traffic he does, trying to work back in with Patrick Kane. A follow through, a great save made by Dell.
It hasn't worked. The one that did go in was upstairs, but it was because of the screen by Kirby Dock on that power play goal from Duncan Keith.
DeBrincat able to gain the zone with an opening, fed one in front, score! Tie is broken.
A beautiful entry here by the Blackhawks, and then Alex DeBrincat with a perfect pass to Patrick Kane, who gets in behind Schimmick, right part of your screen, and you see Kane, he was going one speed and then he accelerated to get some separation, and even though Schimmick had to stick around his hands, Kane is able to find that puck and bury it.
And if you watch Aaron Dell, he never located Patrick Kane. He had no idea he was coming down the back door.
And is not any different than a normal Chicago Blackhawks game. This is brought back ahead now, and Saad is there. And so it becomes the 531st consecutive sellout. Saad is in, score! It is 3-3.
have to take a look. Saad was able to corral that puck, and the person in question for me would be to break it on the left side. But a good job by Saad to keep the play alive, and then what a finish. Able to get Dell to open up and slide it 5-hole. A good job by the Blackhawks to keep their foot on the gas here in the second period.
Bush, what we made mention of a little bit earlier, where the Blackhawks were going high.
Goals in a minute 25 on consecutive shots. Burns feeds one on that's blocked off now by Patrick Kane, and a save had to be made by Dell on him. Poked back across again and retrieved by Nylander. Nicely finessed away, right back in. It's Strome. Strome peeled off. Nylander scores!
What a shot there from Alex Nylander, who starts the play. Strome doesn't want to shoot it, so he plays a little pitch and catch, and he goes top shelf on Aaron Dell.
And Sorensen was a guy that was beat in the neutral zone by Nylander with that quick play, and then he took his time getting back, and that's why Nylander was wide open.
So Sox off this faceoff, a shot, score! A ripper right off the faceoff. Timo Meier really tore that one, gotten back to within two.
Boy, Meier pulls this puck out of the pile and just goes top shelf on Corey Crawford. What a shot.
The leading point getter on the team with 48 now.
That's one of those 50-50 pucks.
Younger brother, or rather his older brother, is here tonight. Works near Edmonton, outdoors for the power company. Can you imagine? Here's a shot, ram off the post, and it is Saad. Top line guy, perhaps because of some absences due to injury, but a top six guy as described by Bob Buchner to us on the plans for San Jose. Is a great shot made there by Kane, and out of the scramble he's able to poke it home, Patrick Kane, and it is now 5-2.
Game here tonight. Good job here getting through the neutral zone. You can see the skill level that he has. Keeps the play alive, kicks it out to Cuckoo, and then Kane is able to find the loose change after the initial shot. But good job by Nylander to create that opportunity through the neutral zone.
How about that pass by Cuckoo? After Nylander did a lot of the heavy lifting, Cuckoo makes a beautiful backhand pass and finds Kane instead of just put it.
And now he's getting those consecutive games. You can see his game really starting to round into form. We're starting to see some vintage Corey Crawford with the way he's played when he won some Stanley Cups.
Dish back by Doc. Score! A blast that came from Kubalik, who's got 30.
Real goal. Terrific work here by Kirby Doc to enter the zone. And what a pass. That is something beautiful. Puts it through two players, and then in the wheelhouse of Kubalik, and boy, can he rip the puck.
Now he got a fortunate bounce there off the stick of Heed. Not sure if Doc was intending to move it laterally, or
the horn from the good ship Blackhawk will sound.